Hi guys, Raza here from Fine Focus Films, and we are back with another video after long absence, and we will provide you some more updates on the story of Kavan, that how Kavan is doing and what's happening on the ground. So as you all know, Dr. Amir and his team went on a short break and they came back almost a week ago, and during that break the crate making process started, and as they arrived the crate was ready and it was transported to Islamabad Zoo. So talking about Kavan's crate, the crate was made in the outskirts of Islamabad, where the workers work on the crate and they build the crate before time. So talking about Kavan's crate, all the specifications were given to the team which were building the crate by the foreign experts of Forpas and the other team members involved, and they gave all the specifications of how a crate should be made. And a crate was built in the outskirts of Islamabad with the help of local engineers and the local staff available. So Dr. Amir and his team came back and they all inspected the crate along with the foreign experts from the Forpas, and they decided that the crate was having some technical issues, due to which they decided to build another crate, and the present crate will be used for the training of Kavan and it will be transported to Islamabad Zoo, which they did. So the Forpas team could not undo the crate which was already made, and they have to redo and they have to make a new crate, but the one which was available is now going to be used for training. So crate training is a very important aspect for all the animals, especially big mammals. They have to get used to the crate before they can be transported in a crate or a cage. So they are being given training that how they can get more familiar with the crate. They can go inside, they can feed in there, and in a similar way, when they get used to it, they are transported in those crates. So the teams, they decided to move the crate, and this crate will be used for training purposes. So Kavan is free to play with the crate, free to break it, free to mold it, free to do anything with the crate he can do. And this is how he's gonna get familiar with the crates. All the foreign teams, Forpas International, Free the Wild, and all the volunteers, animal rights activists, and all other people from Islamabad who are volunteering and helping in this cause, they were all present on the site and they were waiting for the crane to arrive and the low bed truck to arrive on which the crate could be transported to Islamabad Zoo. It was a whole day long process, and there were efforts of all the volunteers and all the team members. So all the volunteers and team members, they were all present there and they were helping, they were giving a helping hand. And it was a very long and lengthy process. It was a very technical sort of process because everything has to go according to the plan. And as always, the man with the plan, Dr. Amir, he took the lead and he explained everything. He explained everyone about their jobs, that who is going to do what. So in this way, the crane was moved from the site to Islamabad Zoo. So one of the process was lifting up the crate and putting it on the crane, and it will come to Islamabad Zoo. But inside the Islamabad Zoo, there are no roads for heavy traffic or for heavy vehicles that they can come in. So they have to make special ways. There were wires, there were other things. So the drivers and the other team, they were all onto it and they did a very well job. So inside the Islamabad Zoo, all the team members, all the volunteers were waiting for the crate to arrive and see that how it's going to go inside, how the crane is going to lift it up and how it's going to be placed inside the Carvan's enclosure. And once the crate is inside the Carvan's enclosure, how Carvan is going to react to it. So that was a very lengthy process, but it was all done smoothly, swiftly, and everybody was safe. So as you can see in the footage, that the crate was moved on a truck and the driver was really an expert driver, and the crane lifter, he was also very expert. They did everything according to the instructions given to them by Dr. Amir and the 4PAS team, and they did exactly what they were being asked for. While on the other hand, Islamabad Wildlife Management team members, they have to make Carvan busy so that he doesn't come in the front of the enclosure where they are going to place the crate through the crane, because there's a lot of sound, and whenever there's a lot of sound, there's a lot of work going on, Carvan does get distracted and he is in front of the enclosure. So to avoid that, there was a plan in place, and Dr. Amir instructed all of the Islamabad Wildlife Management Board members who are working with Carvan, who daily feeds Carvan. So they were there and on different places inside the enclosure, they were there feeding Carvan. So if Carvan is feeding on this side, then suddenly if he goes on the right side, there was another guy who could feed him there. And so they all could keep Carvan occupied and busy so Carvan doesn't interrupt in the process of placing the crate inside his enclosure. So obviously one of the interesting part was that we all wanted to see how Carvan is going to react when he's going to see a crate inside his enclosure. And this was really a very nice thing to see, to witness there, that there was something definitely new and Carvan is going to react to it. Carvan is going to play with it. This is why this crate was there. So let Carvan get familiarized with the crate, because ultimately he's going to travel in the crate similar to this. So this is now the training. What you see, that Carvan is trying to break it, trying to push it, and soon he will go inside the crate and he will be fed there inside the crate. So in this way he's gonna get familiarized with the crate. Obviously we cannot train Carvan to get familiarized or get used to with the crate in just one night, so it will take some time. Dr. Amir said it will take at least 10 days or 12 days or maybe around about 2 weeks. So this is the time. Now the Carvan's crate training has started, and today is the first day, and he did break some parts of the crate, but this is why the crate is there. Let Carvan move freely, let Carvan to get know the crate, and after that's been done, the real crate is going to come in, and in that crate Carvan will be lifted and relocated to Cambodia soon. So we've got all of the footage of this experience, of this action that took place at Islamabad Zoo, and we got the footage of Carvan playing with it, trying to push it, trying to break it. He's trying to get familiarized with this crate, and soon there will be a new crate here in which Carvan will be relocated once he gets his training completed. So guys, this is it for today, for this episode. And if you are concerned about the bears, there's some information that bears export permit and import permits both were issued. Import permits were issued by the sanctuary in Jordan, and the export permit was issued by Ministry of Climate Change, the CITES permits. And bears are fit to travel and they will be leaving soon. As far as Carvan is concerned, his import permit is being issued by Elephant Sanctuary Cambodia, and we are waiting for Ministry of Climate Change to issue its export permit, which will be done soon in the coming days, and then Carvan will be on his way to Cambodia Elephant Sanctuary. So guys, this is it from me for now, and please do comment and do share the video and stay tuned for more updates on Carvan, and let's hope Carvan flies to the freedom safely.